In this video, we will learn how to build your very own 3D printed drone from scratch. I'm using a 3D printed frame, but if you don't have a 3D printer, then you can easily get drone frame from a local market or online sites. I have divided the video into a chapters. One chapter is completed, our next chapter is unlocked. We will be using these components. First, the brain of the drone. I'm using a APM 2.8 flight controller. You can use by your preference. Power distribution board, XT60 connector for battery, 4 brushless motors, 4 ESC for BLDC motors, 4 propellers, 2 clockwise and 2 counterclockwise. FlySky FX-I6X transmitter and receiver. Lithium polymer battery. 20 cm battery strap, nuts and bolts, and some additional parts, GPS module with compass for stability and features, anti-vibration shock absorbers, Sky SC IMX B6 charger to charge your LiPo batteries, LiPo voltage checker, and a power module. We will also need these tools: soldering iron, dual-sided tape, zip ties and scissors and pliers. Let's talk about the heart of our drone, the 3D printed frame. I have printed this frame with PLA and PETG. The frame is available on Thingiverse. It is easy to print and it takes around 35 hours to print. I have printed this bottom plate in PETG. It is strong but has a flexibility in it. I have printed these 4 arms, 2 plates for body, and these 4 are landing gears. Also, I have printed this stand to hold our GPS module. After printing, I have inserted M3 insert nut into arms. I will suggest if you have an ABS material, then go for it. ABS, PLA and PETG are good filament for this frame. If you don't have a 3D printer, then you can purchase these type of frame online. Now that our frame is ready, it's time to put it all together. Let's take our BLDC motor and attach it to the arm. Make sure to match screw positions. To secure the motor with the arm, I'm using a M3x10 bolts. Make sure the screw you are using is not too big or else it will hit the inner coil of the motor. Make sure it is not loose. Now it's time to connect the ESC to the motor. ESC will regulate the speed of the motor. I'm placing the ESC to the bottom of the arm to secure it from the propellers. So for that, I'm moving motor wires accordingly. Connect the middle wire of the ESC to the motor. And after that, connect these 2 wires. Afterwards, if you want to change the rotation of the motor, then just interchange these 2 wires, which are connected to red and black. I'm secure ESC to the arm with the zip ties. Now our arm is ready. Similarly, I have created these other arms. Let's connect these arms to the bottom plate. I'm using a M3x10 screws. As you can see, our drone structure is taking shape. To give the power to the ESC, we need a power distribution board. Power distribution board is to provide power to all ESCs. We have these 4 female connectors and this one is for battery. This PDB supports 8 motors, but we are using only 4 of them. Now our PDB is ready. Let's connect all the ESCs to it. time to attach the upper plate. Attach stand for GPS. I forgot to add the bottom stand. We need to assemble the anti-vibration stand before placing it onto the frame. The flight controller is placed in the middle of the quadcopter. So for that, we need to attach the anti-vibration pad in the middle. I'm using a double tape to attach the flight controller, same as the anti-vibration pads. This forward direction arrow facing the front side of the drone. Also, place the flight controller in the middle of the drone. Now, it's time to connect our ESC to the quadcopter. Connect the front right motor to output pin 1, opposite arm motor to pin 2, front left motor to pin 3, and opposite arm motor to pin 4. Make sure orange wire is a signal and it attached to the signal wire of the flight controller. Now it's time to connect the remote control receiver. In the receiver, first pins are signals. Connect that 3 wires to the input channel of the flight controller. I have provided this color code so you can understand very well. After that, connect channel 2 to 6 only signal wires. We only want signal positive and ground for channel 1. Stick the receiver on the drone in the safe position. Connect the GPS stand onto the drone and stick the GPS on it. Make sure the GPS forward direction arrow face the front side of the drone, same as the flight controller. Connect the GPS wire and compass wire to the flight controller. Connect the power module to give power to our flight controller and ESCs. I have created another video for drone configuration process covering every setting and tweak to optimize performance. Due to a time constraint, I won't cover it in this video. You can check it out separately to configure your drone. Reconnect the battery to the drone. And move the throttle to the bottom right to arm our drone. Check the rotation of the all motors. These two clockwise and these two are counterclockwise. If any motors spin in the wrong direction, then disarm the drone by moving the throttle to the bottom left. And interchange the ESC wires which are connected to the red and black wires of that motor. Attach the battery strap to our drone frame. Make sure the battery is on the middle of the drone, so the weight ratio becomes stable. Full charge the LiPo battery and attach the battery on it. Please remember, always charge a LiPo battery with a good LiPo charger or it may damage the battery on long run. If you want to use a GoPro on the drone, then you can print this bracket. It's time for propellers. Insert the coupler bracket onto each motor. While attaching propeller, make sure the R is written on the propeller's name, which will go to the clockwise spinning motors, and the other one, which has only numbers, will go to the counterclockwise. Insert the coupler and tighten it with the Allen key. connect the voltage indicator to the battery and don't forget to set a low voltage. If our drone's battery reaches that voltage, it will start its low battery beep sound. Connect the battery and we are ready to take off. I'm turning on the drone just to show you how it spins. Please don't turn on the drone in your home or office. It may harm you or your surroundings. Always find the open area like a playground. Keep in mind that propellers are very strong and sharp. So while flying, make sure that no human, animal, birds or other living things gets harmed. Now our drone is ready to take off. Connect the battery to it, place the drone on the ground and maintain a distance from it. Arm the drone and slowly increase the throttle. If you are a beginner, remember, when a drone is lifted from the ground, don't increase the throttle all the way up. Just fly the drone few centimeters above the ground and maneuver it and feel the throttle's response. After hovering for few minutes, gently push the throttle to increase the height. If you want to hold the drone at a specific height, then change the mode to altitude hold. While landing, just remember not to decrease the throttle all the way down or else your drone will collapse on the ground. And if you crash your drone, don't worry. Remember, mishaps are just a part of learning. Here are some of my own crashes. Stay focused and keep practicing. As you continue on this drone journey, it's essential to stay persistent and learn from each experience. With the time, your piloting skills will improve. Speaking of which, here are some of my cinematic shots after few crashes. Practice will be your best friend in this adventure. Happy printing and happy flying.